their house of cards just went up in flames, and it's not even those slow burning flames, it went up like and dust.
Hey guys, welcome to my channel. If you're new, well, where have you been? Thank you for joining me today on today's reaction slash review. If you don't know or you didn't read the title, maybe thumbnail just brought you here. Today I'm reacting to Love, the K-drama. It's a K-drama on Netflix. Love, Fisher and Marriage and Divorce, season 2, episode 8. I watched season 1. I think I gave a reaction of season 1. I would find a video if I did. I'll drop a card up above. But season 2, I wanted to do a reaction starting from episode 7 because I really wanted to get a feel of what the series is like, or the comeback, which is season 2, was like before I go ahead and give a reaction. So I already did a reaction on season 2, episode 7. I'm dropping a card above. Now we're doing episode 8. Two episode drops each week on the weekend, Saturday and Sunday. So now we're doing the reaction for episode 8. Now I want to give a little disclaimer going forward. It's not going to be like your everyday reaction that you just see the tiny screen with the entire movie showing and I am reacting to it. So if that's what you came here for, you might want to exit. But this is what I'm going to do. It's an entire movie. There's nobody that's going to give you that copyright to do that, or just reacting to the entire movie on the lower corner of the screen. So this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to be giving a little tidbit of the clips below, but not throughout the entire video. Like if I feel it's something that is worth you seeing what I am reacting to, you get a little clip of it, maybe 20 seconds, 30 seconds clip of it down below. Otherwise it will just be me watching and reacting to what I am watching, if that makes sense. Now before we go ahead and continue this reaction, which this intro has been a very long one, before we continue with this reaction, guys, if you like content like this, because the only way I will keep creating content is by getting the feel of what you guys like and don't like. If you like me creating content like this, smash that like button, and then comment down in the comment section below, like, you know, you like the comment, or just interact if you've seen the movie, if you haven't seen the movie, what you're expecting, what you thought of some of the things I highlighted or talked about. That would make me know that, oh, this is a content you engage with, so I can create more of it. Also, if you do have any recommendation of movies, dramas you want me to see or react to or review, drop it down in the comment section below as well. So without wasting more time, all disclaimers done, let's get straight to this reaction. And I must warn you, as we're doing this reaction, I like to drink, eat, you know, just feel comfortable when I'm watching a movie. It's more natural for me that way. So you might see me doing that. Don't come for me and be like, oh, that's disrespectful doing that and eating. It's just my everyday life. So just thinking that you're watching my everyday life. I'm going to have to, you know, put a timestamp on this video. That intro was way too long. Alright. And let's start. Oh, that's she is pissed. Very honest. I mean, I felt like season 7 was hot. I don't expect episode 8 to, like, you know, meet the drama of Ariel going for her hair, and, you know, I mean, all of her anger is well deserved. Let's not, like, take away from that. It was a well deserved PC fit. To say Aaron is lucky in the sense that, let me just see, watching from season 1, infidelity is not to be excused. I'd rather you break up with a person than to, like,
you know, put them through the pain of infidelity. But that being said, Hearing's marriage is strange. She and her husband are not compatible. I felt the husband should respect her enough to break up with her before going ahead with the entire thing. But still, his own infidelity is the one infidelity I kind of excuse. Does that make sense? Please let me know that in the comment section below if you feel like I feel sympathy for him. I feel sympathy for his mistress. I still feel sympathy for Hearing in herself in the entire mess. And can we just say, like, seriously, where I live, I've seen some showdown go between some housewife and some mistresses, and it is not pretty. Some housewife gets a bit down, and I am seeing this girl, she's just so respectful. And there's, we don't even call there's a relationship, or like that one night just cost a child or created one. Anyways, let me continue. Hearing is mad, she's asking her age, and she's answering very respectfully, which I think is the right way to handle the situation. Like, if she just reacts the way Hearing is reacting, it might just escalate things. It's going to be a long video, people. Get your coffee, get your popcorn. She feels betrayed, she's walking in on them all having dinner together, like, ooh, did people just replace me? But let me just say something. Erin is gutsy. Like, I understand she's going through rage right now, but other women, because their in-laws, that they might handle the situation differently. But the way she's handling the situation is the way I expect someone of her character, since she doesn't want to handle this situation. She has always been outspoken, even in the face of her in-laws. Like, nope. She speaks her mind, she does what she wants to do, doesn't make any difference. So it's not like her reaction is that's different. Oh, she just called an Ajuma. Okay, I'll just Hearing isn't helping the situation at all. Like, I know she's a woman scorned, but like, this girl has been so likable to the in-laws, even to a boyfriend who happens to be your husband. So like, they've been, even before you came into the scene, they've been comparing the both of you. Like, I feel like the boy's parents are kind of being understanding, like, yeah, with a wife like her, seeing this kind of, you know, malleable woman that does suit his kind of personality, I understand why he's cheating.
We all of us are probably thinking the same thing too.
So with her acting like this, and the girl is being the, you know, the respectful one, I don't know, it will just make, this boy should file for divorce already. I'm like, this boy, the one supposed to file for divorce first, even before the professor and his wife. Together. Oh, she saw the ring, she saw the ring. Just in the ring. Please. But I don't lie, you bought her the ring, please. Oh God, no, why did you say it? Oh my God. If I can see the betrayal in Hearing's eyes. You just asked for her to end it in front of the mistress. I know. No, 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 no. This girl, oh my goodness, she's slapping him too. This actor has taken so much slap in this movie. Let's just give it to him, like, the leverage of slaps. Like, this one's a good actor. It can't be hand to cheek slap because it's a lot of slaps. In front of his parents, stop it! Oh, see?
인스턴트 미역국 보낼 나한테 이혼하고 싶다고 못 살겠다고 한 거 설득시키고 아내 입장 대변해주고 그러다 전부 다
떠나게 됐고 오 마이 갓 The House of Cards just went up in flames, and it's not even those slow bunny flames, it went up like stardust. What? Mistress just opened her mouth and spoke like, I forgive her something though, like everybody's talking about the cheating, about the pregnancy, nobody's talking about the core problems in the marriage. They're just talking about, oh, you walked out on me, or you got another woman pregnant, how did this happen? I mean, you to me, to one another, the other. But nobody's addressing that it was a core problem to begin with, and that's why all this happened from space. And Mistress just like blew up. Woman was slapping the guy too much. We all saw that, so like. I am enjoying the mess too much. Like, why am I enjoying the mess? I agree with you. Hey, now you hit him in front of his parents. This is grimy. Like, seriously, girl. It's just divorce. Marriage is hard. Oh no, why did you just broke my heart? This is not fair. This is abuse of emotions, director. Oh my god, I feel so raw. Why? Okay, let me recap. So there was the scene. Aaron was slapping her husband senseless. Mistress opened her mouth. She dropped a lot of sense. And Aaron was like, yeah, drop the paper, let's get divorced. And now they're reshooting the scene that the mistress was thinking all of this in her head and she didn't say a word and the boys are getting slapped. Oh, for the love of God, why would the directors do this to me? This is not fair. I wish this played out the way it was playing out in her head. I don't like this. I mean, this might make everything stop and Arian stop being a hot mess, but still. It's not your eye. This situation is messed up. I feel worse for the husband. He's frustrated. I don't know why I feel like. Obviously, I feel bad for Harriet, but like she's overplaying her hands. And like, girl, you caught yourself for a doctor that don't want you. Now you're in the hospital. It's like. Please, what is this Dr. Shin's stepmother doing to his wife? I don't know what she keeps putting in her drink. They've not even let us in on what she keeps putting in her drink. I have to say something. Mrs. Shin, I wish I feel like her husband is the sleek adulterer
among all of the adulterers.
Is it adulterers they call them?
I think it is. It is, right? Well, anyway, cheating husband. I feel like he's the slickest of them all, and the reason why Dr. Shin is the slickest of them all is because his wife wants to play dumb. I don't know if she wants to play dumb or she's just like straight up dumb at this point. Because when they first showed all three wives, I thought she was the smartest of them all. Yeah, she has this cruel side of her which she shows to her mom, but I felt she was the smartest of them all. But as the story progresses now, like, nobody's more stupid than her. I understand where her stupidity comes from. Like, her husband hasn't given her any reason to doubt her, him. But I feel like the crumbs are there, and I don't blame her for not chasing. Like, if you're looking for something, especially when it comes to a cheating partner, you will find what you're looking for if you look hard enough. So maybe she just doesn't want to look at this point. I understand that, but at the same time, like, girl. And now she's caught up in a situation. The guy's got a mistress who he bought a car. Mistress is, I don't know, going on a rampage, which I don't know how to turn out for her, but that one is there. You have a mother-in-law who's, I won't say she's in love, because, but I don't know, he's very weird, pedophilia, even though he's an adult now, but there's a weird grooming culture going with this woman and the husband, so I don't know about that. I think she's slowly poisoning the wife too. So the woman is stupid and she has dangers all around. She's like, like the perfect photo just came into my head of what she's like. That's what she's like. She's like that, the Tango movie with the sword in front of the face. Just let me die. Girl, he's still wearing heavy makeup in bed. Oh, Ariel needs some, I don't know. Like, how are you still feeling made up in bed and still have skin to wear makeup afterwards? Like, you gonna break out? And why? His parents are walking on eggshell. I mean, I get why they're walking on eggshell around Ariel, but like, this thing is volatile at this point. Surely they know that. I'm sorry, I just saw something. Let me go back. Their fridge is so empty. Even when I was a student, I didn't have a fridge that empty. Like, how are you married to people in one house? Like, I didn't see bottled water. It was like a new fridge and just the food he bought from the restaurant. Like, how? I want to go back and make sure I saw what I saw. Like, a couple's fridge is that empty. No wonder she's so skinny. She doesn't eat anything. And so sleek and so smooth. Dr. Shin, I have to give it to you. You are the player. In fact, you are the poster child for all playing husbands. Like, how do you doubt a husband like this? I know he's cheating and I'm even falling in love with his cheating ass. A long time. Oh, come on, she's not stupid. I won't suspect a husband like this either. Who am I to suspect you? Like, you think she's stupid and then you see him do things like this and you're like, girl, no, this is a devoted husband and father. He's into the romance, sweeping you up your feet, the splurging. How do you not love that? I am in love. I don't blame the mistress for even like drinking herself to being hospitalized. It's like this love.
Oh, 생각 없어. 생각 없을 사람은 나야. 볼 자랐다고. 잘한 거 없어서 입맛도 없어. 비아냥이야? 아니. 얼굴은 반대거든.
잘못한 거 없단 얼굴. This is almost like a mother and son relationship than even a couple's relationship. It's so much. Okay, making me hungry. My coffee is finished. I need to eat something. Oh god, you gave him food. You're still going to fight him eating the food. He'll lose his appetite.
미친 거 아니고 그런 아줌마 사랑한다고? 아줌마 유혹하는데 넘어가서 사랑. 진짜 대전 동네가 웃을 것이야.
Oh god, woman, let him eat. There's some kind of mushy, let's all put our feelings in the table kind of things that make me cringe. It doesn't like settle well with me, and this is one of them. This seems like, let me get it over with. They are not coming back. If they shoot that docile ghost anymore, I'm going to lose it. This is another storyline I feel like is wasted. I don't know where they are going with it. So the review I did on season 1, I had a problem with some characters and I'm like, where are we going with their storyline? And that is with the Oriental Doctor, who we now know is Dr. Shin's mistress, biological father, or birth father. And these two brothers, which, what's his name again? Like, his character is not developing that. I don't even take note of his name. That would be Haeryong's radio show, the producer. Is he the producer? Yeah, he's the producer. Or the engineer of our show. Him and his younger brother. Although the younger brother dated, what's her name? Point B. Those characters are not developing. Oriental Doctor's character, I don't know what they're doing with that. I mean, I felt like the ending, it was his own storyline that gave kind of opening for season 2, like, oh, we're going to dig into that. He's going to find out that his birth daughter has been the one cheating with that doctor, but we're in episode 8, nothing has happened with that storyline. Now these two brothers, what are we doing with them? We're doing scenes with them, but like, where? Ha! Okay, the brother is egotistic, I see, but I don't think what he's saying is entirely far-fetched. Because now he's of the understanding that, oh, Gabin still wants him, Nan Gabin still wants him, and she marrying whoever she's marrying is just for sure. Of course, his brother makes a good argument of, oh, the world doesn't revolve around you, she probably is just getting married for marriage sake. But with statements Nan Gabin has made in the past, I think she's just marrying Professor to get to him. I feel like if he went there and was like, ah, I want you back, she would gladly, like, dumb Professor and just beat him, so I don't think what he's saying is all that far-fetched. I wonder when it goes for that, visit to his girlfriend's room. I wonder his acting skills will clear up. Rounds. Oh, that's a good rounds.
미국 지인분 따님이네. 혹시나 했더니.
네. 그래서 우리 병원으로 오신 거네요.
드레싱.
네, 응급실에서.
깨워볼까요?
Your lies just keep twisting and twisting.
일이실 남았죠.
네.
Now he's telling the colleague, oh, just like I expected. She's the daughter of a friend. She has been your girlfriend, your cousin. And now Dr. Shin and his mystery story is just... Personally, I think the person Mr. So, the engineer of the radio show, likes is the writer. But Ryeong just feels full of herself, like everybody likes her, so I understand that. Then, as for Mrs. Shin, oh, they don't take their husband's name, right? They don't do that. I don't know her name, anyways. The doctor's wife, I think Mr. So just sees her as a very devoted housewife, like she's all about her husband and how he's no doting on her. I don't think he would go there. I really think he's the writer. This is another character that story is not developing. I know, but at least with our own story, I feel like we'll see the end. It will probably, she'll probably die. Her daughter will regret all the hate she gave her when the daughter is going through the same thing. So there's an end to a character being important, but right now the character is useless to me. She doesn't have family, at least not the ones that care enough to look after her.
여보세요?
야!
이모.
이모군 나발이고 네 엄마 쓰러졌어. 발걸음도 안 했대며.
오셨어요, 한국에?
그래, 지금 늘 병원 가고 있어.
저기, 어쩌다...
몰라, 꼬리 말이 아니야. 다 죽게 생겼어. 이럴 때까지 기집애야 발걸음 안 했다고?
바로 갈게요.
She's such a terrible daughter. She's a terrible, terrible daughter. And I feel like... For Jia's mom, everything is going to come crashing on her heart. She's going to have the biggest heartbreak of this series when the writers finally get there. Because she hates her mother for something that she is probably going to do. And she has thrown their entire relationship down the drain for that same thing. Slap her! I don't know. Me, my sister, you treat my... Violence is never the answer, ever. Violence is never the answer, but as an auntie, my sister came to this country, you are in proximity of her and she's been suffering. Oh no, child, I'll treat you like the insolent child you are. Give her another slap. Slap it, slap again, slap again, slap again. Don't keep face like that, you're rubbish daughter. Now you want to stay by her side. Nonsense.
머리는 안 아파?
Oh, yeah. Will our world come crashing down now?
Oh, Father, please give me something. This is going to be sweet, sweet revenge. For all that she has done to her mom, for her to now see this, the girl with the jacket, man. Oh, God, I wonder how Dr. Shin will lie his way out of this. If he lies his way out of this and she believes this, then there's something seriously wrong with her. Then she's stupid. Then she's stupid.
뺨 좀 대주면 안 돼?
오마, don't make noise, don't make noise. Let it be one of those dolls that have peeping holes, Father, please. She doesn't have to, like, peeping holes, Lord. Peeping hole doll. Peeping hole doll. Peeping hole doll. Peeping hole doll. Peeping, peeping. Oh, yes, it is. Look, look, look. Girl, don't just open that thing. What are we seeing? Now let's see together, Netflix. Why are they so slow with the reveal? It's killing me. What? Your eyesight is bad all of a sudden. Face. Let us see face. Oh God, I don't like the way they are writing this time. So honestly. I don't know. This is one of the things I like to watch. I don't like this. Yes, she saw her hugging, but she didn't see the face. He didn't go on how with the girl with the jacket. This is something he can lie his way out of. You just see my friend in the US. But, oh God. If they are going to give me that merry-go-round, I'll stop watching. What, your world is crashing down on you? Is it that it? Ooh, you're shaking your head. She's going through all the stages of grief right now. The young can't hear you. The young is in a dream state. His sleek face will lie. He will lie out of this. He will lie his way out of this. He would lie his way out of this. Ah, God, what is this episode 8? I have to wait next week for episode 9 and 10. I am not going to go through season 3. This roller coaster of emotions is not worth it. Your fedora is on the floor, madam. Man has fallen completely in love with Mistress Swinging. I don't like him calling her mistress. I don't know. Just to differentiate for those who haven't seen this. Yeah, I agree. You should tell the in-laws. I think Marion should have told her family, like, there's a child on the way. You can't hide that. Please, they should make this make sense. I'm getting tired. Did Gia just see her grandfather's ghost? I'm tired. Make some storylines make sense, please. Oh.
Okay, what is going to happen? Are you going to confront him? Did you even see the woman's face? What am I doing here? Slick son of a bitch.
I'm in the way. VIP 3호 입원 환자.
He will probably just lie to her. Like, I don't even have high expectations for episode 9, let me be honest. Like, this doctor is so good at lying and his wife is so not interested in getting details of what's been going on. Like, I felt like she fainted too quickly. It's like, it's her heart that faints. She just saw him hugging the person. I thought they would show like she's hugging the person and she saw him hugging Ami and then she would like look at Ami's face and realize, oh, Ami is the girl with the jacket, like everything to be just one big reveal. But still crumbs. She's going to ask about Ami. He's probably just going to give her the lie he's been giving his colleagues, like, oh, she's a friend's daughter from the US. And that'll be it. So I don't really have high hopes. I know they're ending episode 8, or like, ooh, no, this big, this, but I don't have high hopes for episode 8 that he's going to confess or that she saw anything. I feel like it's going to be another big whoop. He's going to explain himself out of. Anyways, guys, that's it for this. Like I said earlier in the video, if you like this kind of content, smash that like button because that's how I would know to creating more of this content. Check the cards up above for episode 7 if you just came here and saw episode 8 for my reaction for episode 7. Do subscribe to my channel. Click that subscribe button, your notification bell, because if this is what you want, depending on how this video is received, then I would have to come back next week with episode 9 and 10 consecutively. So we'll see how that goes. And don't be shy, guys. Comment. I feel like love, featuring marriage and divorce is one of those conversation starter that just keeps going. So don't be shy. Let me hear your thoughts. Is there anything you agree with me on, you or you disagree with me on? Let's discuss that in the comment section below. And also, if you do have any recommendation of movies you think I should see, mind you, I've been doing this K-drama thing before it became a thing globally. I think I was introduced to K-drama in 2005. But then the world or the internet or access to these things weren't as easy as it is now, because now you can get your movie as it comes out. Then I was just getting more of the old stuffs, but you still don't want to get into it. If you do have any recommendation, put it down in the comment section below and we'll go from there. Till next time, stay safe and see you when I see ya. Bye.